Immaculata University's 102nd Carol Night.
Three of the Mighty Max proved they're the queens of the court once again.
Mr. Rogers.
Immaculata is one of the greatest gifts you'll ever know.
There are lots of things that we have here in the archives office, which are special. That's why they're in the archives. But there are some that I count as very special to me. And I think would be special to all of you, too. I thought, first of all, of Carol Night. I thought of Carol Night in the old days and Carol Night that is new. Many of the college traditions that persist here from the first days of the university, college, and to this day, the one that's most important is Carol Night. Carol Night is probably one of the events in Immaculata that has not changed dramatically. Others have. In the early days, there was much more solemnity in receiving the lantern and the procession of seniors into the rotunda. Now it's not just seniors coming in to sing, but we are accompanied by a full chorale, an orchestra, which helps to emphasize the beauty of the music and the beauty and brilliance of Christmas. One of the most important symbols of Carol Night would be this lantern. This is the lantern that was received by the freshmen and then was carried through their 4 years at Immaculata. It carried the colors of their class and it was lit to symbolize the brightness and light of Christmas. In the early 1970s, Immaculata gained national prominence with a basketball team coached by Kathy Rush. In 1972, these underdogs from the East shot themselves into prominence by capturing the title of the first division of girls and women's sports, which is the equivalent NCAA men's teams. Immaculata's team went to the national championships 6 years in a row, and those games changed the way the media and fans thought about the game of basketball for women. In the early days, the Mighty Max did not have a gym to practice. They had to go across the street to the mother house to use the gym there, because remember, our field house had burned down, and they did not have that as an opportunity for practice sessions. When they played their games, many times they played the games at Westchester University in their field. The stands were crowded with sisters, IHM friends, students, parents, just crowded them. Sometimes they were a little bit too loud. Some of the parents had drums, buckets used as drums, and they were told they could not use that. They made too much noise. Sister Mary Blords was the president of Immaculata. She played basketball as a young person herself, so she loved basketball, and she was a very, very devoted proponent of them, among with all the other sisters that would go to the games. Just those sisters, they loved it. Some of them had been students here at Immaculata themselves prior to this time, and they just were so thrilled to see Immaculata's name brought to such fame and, you know, such a notice by other people. I believe that the story of the Mighty Max, maybe from the beginning days to the time that we saw it revitalized in that movie, reminded us of what Immaculata is all about. And I think that's the spirit that supports the university today, that people get together, help each other out, they support each other, they go to the games of all the teams. Now we have men's teams and women's teams, and I think I can see them well supported. I think I chose these stories because they bring Immaculata from the past into the future, and they show you how Immaculata grew at those times, but how they also supported the original spirit of what happened when we opened as Villa Maria College and continue to the days now that we have Immaculata University. One of the activities surrounding the first graduation ceremony was the formation of the Alumni Association. On June 1st, 1925, members of the charter class began to write a constitution for Villa Maria College. Through the years, this association has been fully involved in the life of Immaculata and has supported many activities to bring alumni and current students together. I thought it was important to consider the Alumni Association, an alumni as we say now, as a part of the picture of the growth of Immaculata. From the very beginning days, it was organized by the people who were the members of the first graduating class and has continued to this day as a strong support of Immaculata. I mean, look, even the idea that building's called Alumni Hall. That's a tribute to the alums. That's called that because of their support, you know. It's alums that you see at the Carol Night coming to be a part of that. It's the alums that come to Reunion Day and are part of that experience. Many of them come to view the archives just to see the things of the past that they enjoyed. So I really feel that as a strong support of Immaculata from the very early days to the present day is a very important part of the growth of Immaculata and our existence today. I'm so happy I had the opportunity to present some of the relics that we have in our archives and hope you enjoyed seeing them. And I hope that you take the advantage of times of coming to Immaculata and visiting the archives yourselves. It's a treat to see the growth of our institution from its very earliest days when Mother Camilla traveled over the countryside to buy land to this day when we are now celebrating the growth of our campus by many new buildings and certainly many, many more activities than we had in the earliest days. I hope that I see you all at some point.